Performing technical analysis without charts is like playing basketball without a ball. In this lesson, our goal is to introduce the most common types of charts technical analysts use. The first is the line chart. Here is a 5-year line chart showing the development of the S&P 500 from 2015 to 2019. It's quite straightforward to read. The closing price of each trading day is connected by a line, hence the name line chart. As we can see, there was sideways movement in the S&P 500 before it started increasing steadily until 2018, when global political uncertainty caused stock prices to drop. In the second half of 2018 and early 2019, the stock market recovered successfully. This is a chart you can easily find by going to Google and searching for S&P 500. The next type of chart we'll look at is a bar chart. It's a bit more information-rich than a line chart. A bar chart is composed of bars. No surprise there. Each bar provides three interesting pieces of information. First, the highest and the lowest price of a stock within a given trading day. Then, the opening and closing prices of that day, and the volatility during the trading day. The tiny lines sticking out on each side of the vertical bar are the opening and closing prices, always reading from left to right. The top and bottom of the bar represent the highest and lowest price of the stock. The height of the vertical bar represents the volatility in the movement of the stock's price during the trading day. In other words, the shorter the bar, the lower the volatility in the stock's price. Reversely, the longer the bar, the higher the volatility. Good! Another popular type of chart is the candlestick chart. It was introduced in Japan centuries ago. It provides information similar to a bar chart, but tends to be easier to read, making it simpler to count how many consecutive days of a stock's price decrease or increase have been observed. The rectangular body is called the candle. The top and bottom of the candle indicate a security's opening and closing price for a given trading day. The tiny lines below and above the candle is called the wick. It signifies the high and low price of the security during the trading day. In days when the security closed higher than its opening price, the candle will be unshaded. While days when the security closed lower than its opening price, the candle will be shaded. The advantage of the candlestick chart compared to the bar chart is that it allows us to more easily observe the volatility of the stock price. In addition, it facilitates quicker analysis of opening and closing stock prices. Okay, great. Let's consider one last type of chart. Point and figure charts were popular in the US in the early 1900s. Back then, investors didn't have computers and sophisticated software allowing for the instantaneous construction of, let's say, a candlestick chart. They had to use a different tool. Hence, the point and figure chart is constructed differently, which makes it useful as it provides a distinct perspective. In this type of chart, columns of alternating X's and O's are created on a grid to represent a security's price advancement or retracement, respectively. Interestingly, there is no representation of time or volume. The chart is always drawn on graph paper to facilitate seeing the columns and rows. The vertical axis measures discrete increments of price, while the horizontal axis shows how many times a stock price changed. An analyst can choose a $1 chart, $2 chart, or any other increment of choice for the chart. To construct the point and figure chart, the analyst must determine both the box size and the reversal size. The most commonly used box size is 1 unit of currency. The box size refers to the amount of change in price, represented by the height of each box. The width has no meaning. Next is determining the reversal size. The most common size is 3, meaning a reversal in price of 3 or more boxes, or $3 in the case of a $1 box size. In this type of graph, X represents an increase in price, while O represents a decrease in price. When a security's price closes up by $1, 1X is drawn in a column. If it closes by $2, 2Xs are drawn, one on top of the other, and so on. As long as the security keeps closing at higher prices, the column of Xs becomes taller. If the price does not increase by at least the box size, no X is drawn. The reversal size determines when to create a new column. In the case of a $1 box size and a $3 reversal box size, a decline of $3 or more would result in a new column of O's. Again, keeping the rule of a $1 box size and $3 reversal box size, each filled-in box with an O represents a $1 decline. So, as long as the downtrend continues, without a $3 price increase, O's are added to the column, one below the other. Thus, a reversal of an increase of $3 would prompt a new column of X's, and so forth, forming the point and figure chart pattern. The power of this chart is that it clearly illustrates price levels that may signal a change in a stock's price trend. It also shows the price levels at which securities most often trade. Very well. These are some of the most famous types of charts used in the world of technical analysis.